Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And if you're new here, my name is Ubu Gaswin Uche. Super excited to be here again. And today I have with me
Faro, guys.
Alright guys, today we'll be reacting to conversation between Jesus and Allah. Surah
Sulemaida.
Okay, Surah Sulemaida. Verse 109 to 120. Yes. That was too much of your time. Let's get right into this.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يوم يجمع الله الرسل فيقول ماذا أجبتم قالوا لا علم لنا إنك أنت علام الغيوب يوم يجمع الله الرسل فيقول ماذا أجبتم قالوا لا علم لنا إنك أنت علام الغيوب إذ قال الله يا عيسى ابن مريم اذكر نعمتي عليك وعلى والدتك إذ أيدتك بروح القدس تكلم الناس في المهد وكهلا وإذ علمتك الكتاب والحكمة والتوراة والإنجيل وإذ تخلق من الطين كهيئة الطير بإذني فتنفخ فيها فتكون طيرا بإذني وتبرئ الأكمه والأبرص بإذني وإذ تخرج الموتى بإذني وإذ كففت بني إسرائيل عنك إذ جئتهم بالبينات فقال الذين كفروا منهم إن هذا إلا سحر مبين وإذ أوحيت إلى الحواريين أن آمنوا بي وبرسولي قالوا آمنا واشهد بأننا مسلمون إذ قال الحواريون يا عيسى ابن مريم هل يستطيع ربك أن ينزل علينا مائدة من السماء قال اتقوا الله إن كنتم مؤمنين قالوا نريد أن نأكل منها وتطمئن قلوبنا ونعلم أن قد صدقتنا ونكون عليها من الشاهدين قال عيسى ابن مريم اللهم ربنا أنزل علينا مائدة من السماء تكون لنا عيدا لأولنا وآخرنا وآية منك وارزقنا وأنت خير الرازقين قال الله إني منزلها عليكم فمن يكفر بعد منكم فإني أعذبه عذابا لا أعذبه أحدا من العالمين وإذ قال الله يا عيسى ابن مريم أأنت قلت للناس اتخذوني وأمي إلهين من دون الله قال سبحانك ما يكون لي ما يكون لي أن أقول ما ليس لي بحق، إن كنت قلته فقد علمته، تعلم ما في نفسي ولا أعلم ما في نفسك، إنك أنت علام الغيوب، ما قلت لهم إلا ما أمرتني به أن اعبدوا الله ربي وربكم، وكنت عليهم شهيدا ما دمت فيهم، فلما توفيتني كنت أنت الرقيب عليهم، وأنت على كل شيء شهيد، إن تعذب إن تعذبهم فإنهم عبادك، فإنهم عبادك، وإن تغفر لهم فإنك أنت العزيز الحكيم. قال الله: هذا يوم ينفع الصادقين صدقهم، لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا، رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه، ذلك الفوز العظيم. لله ملك السماوات والأرض وما فيهن، وهو على كل شيء قدير.
Wow. You know, looking, listening to it, like I just had chills all over my body, and talking about Jesus and the conversation he had with God, you know, he was the followers or his disciple. Actually, he wanted a sign to know truly, truly,
this is
you. We are following you. Let us know what we are doing is right. Okay, talk to your Lord. Let him send us a table. Okay, and he did. And it got to a point here, like, you see, there's something I could actually relate to what's happening now, especially with the Catholic. I don't mean any offense. You see, he says, have they made him a deity? Has he told them to make him and his mother a deity? You know?
Yes.
Which is like, after God, they come in and
they idolize him, yeah, and that kind of thing.
And he was like, he never said so. If he had said that, God himself would have known, because God is the person who knows everything, both the one someone has spoken and the one that is yet in the person's heart, you know? And look at right now, you see some certain churches you go to, and you see they have a mold of so-called Virgin Mary, you know, and they go there and they bow to it, and they bring a cross kind of with a sword, you know.
So the bottom line is that at the end of the day, we should not doubt God, we should not doubt his powers. At the end of the day, he is the mighty, he is the all-knowing, the all-seeing, the wise, and all other. You can't even comprehend how God is. So this verse is just telling us basically that Jesus himself, even with the way we all know how Jesus is, because we value Jesus in Islam, and then at the end of the day, we can see how humble he is to the core. He never called himself son of God. He never called himself sort of son of God. Instead, he called himself the servant of God or son of man. So at the end of the day, if Jesus is following God's directions, and then who are we not to do exactly what God wants us to do?
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, let's just be steadfast, upright, and all and everything.
Yeah. And you see, one thing I always, the Bible, you go and they say these things in terms of, we're talking about idolatry and the rest of that. And you can see today, most Christians, they still do that thing. They believe in some kind of talisman. They believe in some different things that they've made them, they've made taking the place of God. They've used it to be like a connection to God, which God actually didn't want that. Even exactly. in the commandment said, no image like, you know, no like kind of image like to that represent him and the rest of that. But we keep doing those things. And this passage actually said that, you could see when Jesus was like, even me, I didn't tell them that, you know.
No, the biggest sin is in Islam is shirk. Those of you that are conversant with the Arabic word shirk, it means partnership with God. It means you're taking another thing as worship, meaning you are neglecting God and then you are worshiping something else. That's the biggest sin you can actually commit in Islam.
So, guys, I've learned one or two today, and it's amazing. Each time I react to these videos, I like get serious, open, like I become aware of a lot of things that is happening or we should have known all along. I want to say a very big thank you to you guys for sticking with me. It's been an amazing journey. We just crossed about 5,000 subscribers in just a few months. I want to say a very big thank you to every single one of you guys. Say a very, very, very big thank you. And to come away next time, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, guys. Like, share, and subscribe. If you have any suggestions you want us to take into consideration, or any recommendations of any videos, drop that in the comment section. I'll definitely do justice to that. So come away next time. So.